What is up? My name is Marcel and welcome to The Modern Filmmaker. Today we're going over something pretty basic but extremely important, and that is how to get a perfect white balance in post in Davinci Resolve 15. So, if you're like me and you're a running gunner, you like to film fast, you like to film quick, you always have your camera with you, you're shooting all kinds of stuff, then sometimes your white balance might get a little off. Sometimes it might be very off. Whether you're trying to match shots, whether you just want to save a good shot, whatever the case may be, I'm gonna show you a few different ways to fix it and get it spot on. So let's go ahead and jump into DaVinci and get this started. So we're here in DaVinci Resolve 15 and this shot is just a mess. The white balance is all over the place. I was in Beijing, my friend was like, let me film you for a while. You know, you film everything else, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, okay. And I didn't want to go over white balance and focus. You can see the focus is slightly off, the white balance is off. I just told him, just try to hold the camera steady. So this is the shot we got. And you can see it's pretty yellow. You don't even have to look at the scopes to tell that this white balance is very off. But if we do look at the scopes, you can see what's going on over here. The reds and the greens are way up there and the blues are pretty down low. So the first way I'm going to go over, and this is the most simple way to do it, is to just click this little button here on the bottom left hand corner and click that. It'll give you, it's the white balance tool, it'll give you this little dropper here and you just need to click something white. Now from what I remember, this thing in the background was white. And the shirt I was wearing was also white. So I'm gonna go with the shirt, I'm gonna click that, and boom. Now we can see here, it may look kind of funky in the scopes. Now that's because if we reset this, you can see this in the scopes, the green highlights are all the way up at the top. They're very small, I hope you guys can see them, and so are the red. But the blue highlights actually end about right here. They don't go, there's a kind of a huge gap in between them. Most of the highlights end right here. And there's a little bit up here, but most of them end right here and there's not much in between. So by hitting this little white balance tool here, boom, they really level out. Brings down the reds a bit, it pushes up the greens a little bit, and it pushes up the blues a lot, which is beautiful. That's a very quick and easy way to do it. And if we want, we can go here into the primaries bars and turn down the Luma Mix, because first of all, if you do not turn down the Luma Mix, what's gonna happen is, let's say I change this blue here. Look over at the scopes as I do this. I'm gonna bring the blue down and you'll see the greens and the reds go up. It kind of affects the other things in the scopes. Whereas, let me reset this, whereas if I put the Luma Mix down all the way to zero, it will not affect the other two. It will just affect the one color I'm working with. Boom. See that? It's nice. It's beautiful. Very beautiful. So now just this shot in particular, what I would do is go over here to the hue versus saturation in the curves. It's the in these buttons here at the top. You can go over this third one over, hue versus saturation, and I'll go to the blue and I'll also click this light blue here and I would bring these down because some of these blues and there's like a weird greenish blue thing, like an aqua thing happening here, and there's some blues in here that weren't actually there. I personally would just turn this down and you can kind of see what that's doing, and I would turn this aqua color here down. You can really see if I push this all the way up where this is standing out here. I just push this all the way down and we have a much more relaxed, and you can see here it's leveled out those blues quite a bit. So if you have a weird cast of colors that you don't want to be there, the hue versus saturation tool can be a beautiful way of just kind of toning those down or taking them away, because I didn't have to go all the way down, but you know, I did just because I didn't want the blues in the shot at all. I could also go to this purple here because I'm seeing a purple cast on this wall from this red wall, which is totally fine, but if I really just didn't want it in the shot, I could pull that down to where the only color in the shot is my skin tone and this red wall back here and a little bit of this aqua green here. So that's just one way to do it. Just one way to do it. I'm going to reset this and we're going to look at another way to do this. So another way that I like to do this is in the curves, just the first tab in the curves. And you'll have to lock all these. There's a lock button here, this chain link. This is unlocked and this is locked. That locks all these together. Over here at the bottom of the preview window, you can click this and go to qualifier. and then you can click on something that is supposed to be white. Like this thing back here, or like my shirt, which I'm going to choose my shirt in this case. Something kind of bright in the shirt. Bow. Now you can see how it pulled up these dots here. And if I unlink these and go to the red, you can see the red is up here, the green is slightly below it, and the blue is all the way down here. Now what we can do is bring, because we don't have a lot of light in the shot, we can brighten it up and also get those colors level by taking this green and raising it to the reds. Not going horizontally, just going vertically in the shot to match up these dots. And then I'll go over to the blue and I'll also raise these up to where the other two are, kind of right above this line here. And we're getting pretty much the same exact effect as we did with the white balance tool. Bring that up a little bit more. Maybe I'll, yeah. Boom. One reason I love to do it this way in particular is because you can kind of have more control. Because here I can take the blues if I want the shot to have more of a blue cast in the highlights. And I can pull that up. And now we're seeing kind of a cool blue cast from the other lights and the highlighted things in the shot. And even though the scopes aren't totally cool, this is more like stylistic. And that's why I like to do it this way sometimes. It's just to have that extra control over the overall look I want in the shot in particular. Or if you're trying to match shots, then you can use these to really get that control. And you can look back at the other shot and say, you know, what kind of light was casting in this shot on the walls, or what was casting in this shot, and kind of match them here. You know, and I can do the same thing with the reds, or, you know, of course that doesn't look good at all. But I could do that if the shot called for it. I could bring these highlights in the green down a little bit if I wanted it to have more of a red highlight cast. You know, there's just a lot more you can do in that situation. Curves is super awesome. I'm going to make a whole video on curves, so be expecting that very soon. Because there's just so much you can do with just the overall master curve in itself. It's amazing, and it's almost a perfect way to expose if you just use the master curve, but you use it right. So let's reset this, and I'll show you guys the last way that I like to do my white balance. I'm going to go over to the power windows. I'm going to click the circle power window. If you've watched any of my other videos, you see me use this one a lot because it's nice and fast and very accurate. This thing in the bottom left-hand corner, the white balance tool, it's really convenient, but sometimes it does really funky things, especially when you're outside. And let's say you've got the orange from the sun, but the blue from the shade, or, you know, and you're wearing a white shirt and you click on something like that. I'll show you guys that here in a second. It just doesn't always get it right. And sometimes it can be really funky. So this is my quick way of white balancing usually. So I'll go to something white like this here, or like these walls were white. And I can click on the highlight button, and here it's only going to show me the colors in that white. Now, this is not supposed to have any color at all. And the only way to do that is to level all the colors so they're level and balanced, so it goes back to grayscale, which means a lack of saturation. And so what I'll do is bring down this Lumimix and try to match up these little lines. See how the green is here, the blue's down here, and the red is up here. I'm going to match these with the red. So I'm going to bring this green up quite a bit to match that red. I'm going to bring the blue up quite a bit as well. And one thing I like about this and the highlight window in general is you can really see, because this, what's around what you've highlighted, what's not highlighted, I guess, is how you'd say it, is grayscale. It has no saturation. So what you can do is you can use this kind of as a reference. Like, does this look like it's lacking in color just like this is? If I bring this down, you can see it's kind of got a green cast compared to this gray around it. So by bringing this up, you can kind of match that a little bit just with your eye. And that's a really cool way of just kind of a double checking the visual. Because the scopes is really nice, but you know, that's just a great way to double check that everything is level and looking grayscale and non-saturated at all. Now, if we click off that highlight and then click off this power window, boom, we kind of get that same exact effect. Now, it's a little bright because I brought everything up. Now, I could have brought everything down to where the blue was, but then you're kind of pushing things in the shadows. So it really just, you know, it depends on the shot. And sometimes you just got to play around and see where everything is. Now, what I would generally do is bring the entire gain down to where everything is a little bit more level. Now, messing with the different colors is going to mess with the saturation. It's kind of going to take saturation away. So one thing you might want to do just after all of this is bump the saturation up to give those original colors, to put those original colors back in the shot. Now, if I click off, you see this terrible white balance that was there. And if I click on, bada bing, bada boom. Much closer. Now, the shot's a mess because, like I said, my friend had the camera and he didn't know anything about exposure or white balance. So this shot's a mess, but I wanted to kind of show you guys with the shot that was super off. And a lot of my shots in particular, like if I were to choose this shot, this shot's pretty well white balanced. Is it perfect? No, but because there's white in the background, it's very simple. I can easily click this, click on the white, and boom, it levels these out just fine. Now, this is before, the blue's a little lacking, but not that bad. And then you click it back on, it's on. So I didn't want to use a shot like this where you guys wouldn't really learn anything. That's why I chose this shot here, which was just a mess. And I mean, it still is a mess. It needs noise reduction. It needs to be on focus, honestly, which is something you can't change. But also this shot here. This shot is fairly white balanced pretty well. You can see here that we've got a little more greens, a little more blues. But I'll show you guys what I was talking about earlier. If you press this white balance button on a shot like this where you have the sun coming on him, but you've got shade, so it's kind of going to give a blue cast. And I were to click something that's white, like right here, now there's kind of a warm cast on him, and it's not really balanced the way that I would like it to be. So that's why I don't always use that. Now, if you come over here to the primaries bars, there are a few ways you can fix this. Once again, turn down the lumen mix so you don't affect the other layers, color channels, I mean. And I could bring down these highlights, the blue gain a little bit. I could bring down the green gain a little bit. Not too much. And this is looking really good, like about right here to me. So if I click off of this, you kind of see now it's kind of cool. It's very cool. And before, when we clicked that button, it made it a little too warm. But this is a kind of a nice in-between right here. This is kind of a, I really like how this is turning out in this shot in particular. We could raise these so these highlights here match up a little more, but you know, it a lot of it's kind of subjective and kind of what you want to the eye. You know, if I were to level these out, I'll show you what that looks like. That's not the white balance we want, really. I mean, his shirt's blown out, so you know, that's kind of why I went down with everything, so you guys would be able to also see how to recover some highlights there. What I could do is bring down these green midtones a tad. Also the blue midtones a tad. And that looks pretty good. Like, this is where I would start with this shot. I would make a lot more stylistic changes to color grade and color correct after this. But when it comes to just white balance, that's kind of that's where I would start. After this, I'd probably go into exposure and bring down the highlights a bit, just to recover some of these in his shirt and whatnot. Bring up a little bit of these shadows, to recover some of the shadows. And you guys know, if you guys have watched any other videos, you guys know that there's kind of a string of tasks after the white balance. But the white balance is all where it begins. That's where you can match shots. That's where you can really just get things level, on a level playing field, so you can go in and really fix them up and do what you really want to do with the style after that. But first, it all starts with a good white balance. So anyway, like this video, guys. If you guys liked any of this, if you guys learned anything at all, and if you guys would like more videos like this, go ahead and click that like button. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, because I will be posting a lot more here in the future. And you know, leave a comment if you have any questions or you want to see anything in particular that I didn't cover here or I haven't covered in my other videos. So anyway, this is The Modern Filmmaker. Once again, I'm Marcel, and I'll see you guys next time.
Peace!